Welcome back. In this part 2 video of SAP CPI's palette operations, we'll be talking about mapping, transformation, and calls. These three palette functions are a bit complicated palette functions that you would need to build complex interfaces. Let's discuss each one of the palette functions and see how we can use them in the real integration scenarios. Under mapping, we have mapping functions like ID mapping, message mapping, operation mapping, and XSLT mapping. We can use ID mapping when you want to map different identifiers for the same business object. For example, you have an integration scenario where in source system, you call an ID as customer ID, and you have a different system where you call the same ID as partner ID. When you want to map this customer ID to a partner ID, you can use this ID mapping feature. The main benefit of ID mapping is it will ensure data consistency and avoid data duplication. The next mapping function is message mapping. We use message mapping when you want to convert a source structure to target structure. Basically, we can map a XML structure to a JSON structure. In this mapping procedure, we can use graphical mapping, XSLT mapping, or Groovy tool to build complex mapping scenarios. The next operating function is operation mapping. We use operation mapping to map operations of different interfaces. For example, we can map an operation of a request message to an operation of response message. For building operation mappings, you can use a graphical view, or you can also use XSLT or Groovy tool. The last mapping feature is XSLT mapping. If you want to build complex mapping scenarios, you can use XSLT. XSLT stands for Extensible Stylesheet Language Transformations. For example, in XSLT mapping, you can do filtering, sorting, aggregation, and modification of XML nodes to build complex mapping transformations. Let's now talk about the next palette operation segment, which is transformation. We use transformation palette operations when you want to transform a message from source structure to target structure. As you can see, we have different transformation operations like content modifier, converter, decoder, EDI extractor, encoder, filter, message digest, and script. We can use content modifier to modify the content of your payload or your message. For example, you can use content modifier to update headers, properties, or payload fields when the message passes through different states of execution. We can use converter to convert a message from source structure to target structure. These convert palette operations would enable different systems to communicate each other in an understandable language. For example, converter supports CSV to XML, EDI to XML, JSON to XML, XML to CSV, XML to EDI, and XML to JSON. As you can see, this converter operation supports different types of format to enable multiple types of systems to communicate each other. Next palette operation is decoder. As name indicates, this decoder step can be used to decode an encoded message. For example, we can use different types of algorithms and different types of formats to decode a message. For example, this decoder palette operation supports BASE64 conversion, ZZIP decompression, MIME multipart decoding, and ZIP decompression. So as you can see, you can use these palette operations to decode a message into different formats. We can use decoder and encoder to secure the sensitive information when they pass through from source to target system. For example, we have encoder. Basically, it actually works opposite the decoder. We can use encoder to convert a message into some cryptic language to send it to the target system. This encoder palette operations also supports BASE64, ZZIP compression, MIME multipart encoding, and ZIP compression. So by using these formats, you can make sure that whatever the sensitive data we are sending through the integration scenario is secure and safe. Next palette operation is EDI extractor. we can use EDI extractor to extract a message or a segment from EDI message. When you are working with an integration scenario where we use EDI messages between source and target systems, in such scenario, when you want to extract an EDI structure from an EDI message, you can use this EDI extractor palette operation. Next palette operation is filter. Basically, filter can be used when you want to evaluate a condition in your integration flow. We can also use filters when you want to have conditional routing between source and multiple targets. Next palette function is message digest. We can use message digest when you want to calculate cryptographic hash value for your message payload. For example, you have a source system and a target system, and you are sending a payload between source and target. If you want to make sure the integrity of the data between the source and target system, you can create a cryptographic hash value by using this message digest, which ensures the data integrity. The next palette function is script. For example, when you have a complex requirement and you want to use a custom code to build this transformation logic, you can use the script section. Under script component, we have Groovy script and JavaScript. You can use both Groovy and JavaScript to build custom logic for complex transformation mapping requirements. Under call component, we have external call and local call. We can use external call when you want to initiate a communication with an external system or external service. We can use local call when you want to initiate a communication with internal sub-process, for example, a local integration process. Under external call, we have content enricher, poll enrich, request reply, and send. Let's now talk about the palette function content enricher. As name suggests, when you want to enrich your payload message with a different payload, you can use content enricher. For example, you have a requirement. A sender is sending the data to a target system, but you need to enrich this payload with the data from another receiver. In such scenario, you can use content enricher to enhance the payload. When using content enricher, you can have a combined approach or enrichment approach. The next palette operation is poll enrich. You can use poll enrich palette function when you want to enrich your payload by combining multiple files from a receiver. The next palette function is request reply. When you want to enrich your message from a receiver which supports synchronous communication, you can actually use request reply palette function. For example, you have a sender and receiver, and sender is sending a message to the receiver, and you want to enrich this message by doing a lookup to a different receiver. By using this request reply palette function, you can initiate a communication with the receiver in a request message, and you can get the response immediately in a synchronous fashion. The last palette function is send. We can use send function when you want to send a message to a receiver without expecting any reply. Basically, you can use send function when you want to broadcast, distribute, or publish a message to a receiver. Let's now move on to the next palette function under local calls. In local call, we have idempotent process call, looping process call, and process call. The first palette function is idempotent process call. We can use idempotent process call to invoke a process to ensure idempotency. Idempotency means you can invoke the same process multiple times. If you pass the same input, it will produce the same output irrespective of how many times you invoke the process. Basically, idempotency ensures there is no data duplication and ensures data consistency. The next palette function is looping process call. We can use looping process call when you want to iterate the process for multiple times or based on a condition. You can use process call when you want to invoke a separate process or a sub-process within integration flow.